Hello friends, good morning. Now I would like to welcome you to the 8th lecture series of Unit 4, Non-Banking Financial Companies. In this lecture series, we will discuss the hire purchase. In all the previous lectures of this chapter, we have discussed about the lease. Lease as an option of financing, and how leasing is going to help the business people, and what are the characteristics, types of lease, and everything we have discussed in the previous lectures. Now, we'll discuss the other option of financing in a business for costly assets or for properties which are purchased. One more option is a hire purchase. Let us discuss in this lecture series the points pertaining to hire purchase. We will discuss here the meaning, the parties to the contract, to the hire purchase, lease versus hire purchase, how they are different, and advantages and disadvantages of hire purchase. This is a quite common type of buying assets, especially the house, vehicles and all that at the individual level. Hire lease contract is not so common in an individual perspective. Lease is normally adopted by the business people, and especially in a corporate kind of a dealings. But hire purchase is so quite common in today's world that even individual buyers or consumers adopt this. It is not only a source of finance for a big companies or for the business people, but it is also a very good source of finance for small individual consumers. Dear friends, you might have seen many a time in the newspaper advertisement that installment purchases are available, where the seller declare installment buying system. Installment buying system is nothing but a hire purchase. During a Diwali, many announcement will be made by the television selling companies or the refrigerator selling companies, washing machine selling companies, saying that EMI facility is available for purchase. This EMI is nothing but an equated monthly investments to be made by a buyer for buying a asset, buying any product like television and all that. He need not require to pay the full value of the television at a shot, in a one single shot. The television value will be paid in future installments called EMI. When the last EMI is paid, the television will be transferred to the total rights of the television will be transferred to the buyer. So buyer become the exclusive owner of the television. But in when he pays the first installment itself, the possession of the television will be given to the buyer to use. He can use the goods as if he is the owner of the goods, that he can take any decision relating to repair, maintenance, everything of that particular television. But when the last payment is made, he gets the right to sell the property to anybody. So he becomes the full-fledged owner of the television. So it is a facility provided to the people to acquire the assets which are costly in nature. Normally, today, even for buying a costly mobiles like Apple mobiles and all that, the EMI facility is provided by the manufacturers or by the sellers. So this is nothing but a hire purchase system. So hire refers to H-I-R-E. Please students, remember the spelling of hire. It is not H-I-G-H-E-R. Many a time students write hire purchase, H-I-G-H-E-R. It is wrong. H-I-R-E. Hire means badige. Badige. What do you call it? Badi. Acquiring an asset on hire purchase is nothing but getting the assets possession and paying its price in equated monthly installments in the future. So you need not require to pay the price of the product in a one single shot, but you can get that in a installment way. So it is called hire purchase. So the purchase happens once the first installment is made, but the purchase does not give a right to the buyer to sell the property to anybody. That right comes to him only after paying the last installment decided. So in this case, while buying an asset, you are supposed to pay a down payment, and then remaining amount you have to pay in what call as installments. So that is one the special identification of this hire purchase. Now let us see the meaning part of the hire purchase. What is hire purchase is an agreement for buying expensive assets. Any expensive assets is there. It is an option to purchase the assets or goods where the buyer makes an initial down payment. Here the buyer makes an initial down payment and pays the balance or remaining amount with interest in installments. In this case, so the hire purchase EMIs, equated monthly installments, are having two components. One is the price of the product that you are going to pay in installment. Another one is the interest component. Both are included in this EMI. In this case, the buyer is going to pay amount called the assured amount. We call as down payment amount. Down payment in the sense, suppose if a television is around 50,000 rupees cost, when the buyer is buying it on hire purchase basis, the seller does not give the whole 50,000 amount in EMI way. He expects some amount in a down payment, because the down payment is giving the confirmation that buyer is going to pay the installments. If the buyer does not pay any of the installments at that particular moment, the seller is going to acquire the asset for making a default in payment of EMIs, equated monthly installments. So what the buyer is going to do, he recovers the asset. So what the seller is going to do, he recovers the assets from the buyer for making a default for not paying the installments. In such case, any kind of recovery cost, repair cost to the machine, or any of the operating costs are arising, that is being met by the seller out of the down payment that he has received from the buyer. So therefore, down payment is compulsory in most of the hire purchase contracts. They have to make a little amount as a down payment for meeting the expenditures of the hire purchase contract. And the monthly installments or the quarterly installments or installments yearly, which is being discussed between the hire purchase and the buyer, this installment always includes two parts, one called the price component, the other called is the interest component. So every time when the EMI is paid, the EMI is paid the price of the machine, price of the property, plus the interest on the component. So outstanding payments of the price will incur the interest in that particular month, and that balance of the money to be paid will be charged interest by the seller. This is how the seller is going to calculate the equated monthly installments, and this contract is made. With some installment payment plans, the buyer gets the ownership rights as soon as the contract is signed with the seller. In most of these hire purchases, as soon as the seller or the buyer signs the contract with the seller, the ownership is transferred to the buyer. Ownership refers to he can use the exclusive property as if he is the real owner of the property. He can modify, change, repair, do anything relating to the assets. He is having all the rights except the right of selling the product without the knowledge of the buyer, seller. Without the buyer, the knowledge of the seller, buyer cannot sell the asset and get rid of the contract. he has to take the permission from the seller to sell the assets. So this is for the hire purchase contract. Then the examples are purchase of vehicles on installment. Most of the students might have taken the loan from the banks to buy the two-wheelers or four-wheelers. So where the banker gives the loans on a hire purchase system, where all the papers of the rights or all the ownership papers are taken away. If you buy the two-wheeler, for example, during the registration itself, the name of the two parties are registered with the RTO. The two parties are, one is the bank who gives you the this loan for buying the vehicle. Another one is you are the person involved. So you can use the two-wheeler or four-wheeler as per your will and wish. There is no any restriction. You can go anywhere, come. You are the real owner. Suppose if there is any repair to be made, you have to make the repair. If there is any depreciation happens, you have to suffer it. If there is an accident, you have to claim the accidental benefits, or you have to lodge the complaint in your own name. So you are the total owner. But only the ownership is relating to use of the property to the exclusive level. But if at all you want to sell the property before paying the last installment, you cannot sell the property because the right of the selling of the property lies with the seller. So that is what we call as right of sale lies with the seller himself. But the possession rights and usage, all rights are transferred to buyer. So this is what the specialty of this hire purchase. In case of lease contract, the same thing happens. The buyer can use it, do it, everything. But there is no option of purchase. By paying the last installment in the lease contract does not make that buyer becomes the owner of the asset. Because always lesser is the owner of the asset. And if at all he has to sell the asset to the buyer, to the lessee, separate contract has to be made. But in this hire purchase, no separate contract is made. After the last payment of the EMI, the rights of sell by these things, total rights of the product will be transferred from the seller to the buyer. So now the hire purchase buyer, for a so the purchaser under the hire purchase contract, that is for the buyer, can acquire the product at any time, can acquire the ownership of the product at any time by paying lesser. Suppose, for example, the person is given an installment by the seller, 10 installments are given. After paying the second or third installment, if he wants to pay the all remaining 7 installments at a shot, so immediately on the same day, the total rights are transferred from the seller to the buyer. So automatically higher purchase will come to an end. At all the times, higher purchase will come to an end, right? Come to an end by total transfer of assets rights to the seller buyer. So buyer becomes automatically the owner after paying the last installments. So housing loan is also the same example. While constructing the house, the cost is very high. Most of the people will go for housing loans. So in housing loans, down payment is made and a house is acquired. The remaining portion of the price of the house will be paid to the banks on installment basis. On installment basis. If the whole installments are paid on one single day, one single transaction, then immediately the total ownership is transferred. This is what the hire purchase is. Most of the time in hire purchases, the mortgages are made. Mortgage is nothing but pledging or putting the rights of the assets in the hands of the seller. So in case of housing loans, the mortgage is made like in the total registration papers and all that, banker also becomes the owner of the in the asset. So without the knowledge of the banker, in most of the cases, houses cannot be sold. And if the buyer of the house makes a default in paying the installments, so 3-4 installments, if they are pending, then seller may exercise the right to sell the property and recover the whole of the asset value by selling the asset to any party. So in this case, the buyer does not have any right to stop this when he makes a default. So these are the basic characteristics of a hire purchase. Basic characteristics of the hire purchase. We'll see the parties involved in a hire purchase agreement. One is a hirer, is a buyer. Second one is the owner, normally the person who finances or who transfers the asset to the seller, to the buyer. In case of housing loans, car loans, the financial institution is the owner, because even if the asset is purchased by the buyer, but the once it is purchased, the titles will be transferred by way of mortgage or hypothecation. Mortgage is for the fixed assets. When you are buying the fixed assets like land, factories, or houses like that, mortgage will come into the picture. In the mortgage, the asset is pledged with the financial institution, and installments are paid to the financial companies or banks. And after the last payment of the installment, the buyer become the seller, the owner, total owner of the asset. So this is what in hypothecation is for movable properties like vehicles, trucks, and all kinds of things. Movable properties will have a hypothecation. In most of the rickshaws and all that, you might have read the new lines written on the rickshaw that this vehicle is hypothecated to State Bank of India. This vehicle is hypothecated to what you call as Union Bank of India. So if you read that, what is the meaning of this hypothecation? In the sense, the right of selling this movable property lies with the hands of the bank. So the real owner of the property is 100% not the 100% ownership is not there with the owner of the rickshaw, that is user of the rickshaw. It is with some portion is lies with the banker. When the rickshaw owner, the rickshaw buyer pays the last installment, he becomes the exclusive owner. In case of before completion of the purchases, hire purchase installment payments, if the asset has to be sold, the user of that particular the rickshaw can sell it to somebody else with his own negotiation. Price and everything is decided by him as if he is the owner. But at the time of transferring the asset to that another person, the rickshaw owner, that is a rickshaw user, should take the permission of the bank. And if the bank gives the permission, then he can sell it, and out of the sale proceeds, he has to pay all the remaining installments to the banker and end the contract. So this is what the party to the contract is, hire purchase and the owner. During the case of this hire purchase, the owner, that is the financial institution which sanctions the money for acquiring the assets, may not believe the buyer. He may ask for some guarantor. Guarantor is a person having an ability, in case if the buyer defaults, the remaining installments will be paid to the banking institution by this third party. So the guarantor is normally the friend, relative of the hire purchaser. So banker will trust that guarantor, and based on the promises made by the guarantor, loan is sanctioned to the buyer of the vehicles or of the property. So this is how there is a guarantor. And owner may require a hirer to furnish a guarantor or such number of guarantors acceptable to the owner to guarantee the performance of the hirer's obligations under the hire purchase agreement by virtue of Section 20A of the Agreement Contract Act. So this is what it is relating to the parties to the contract. Now let us understand the basic differences between hire purchase and the leasing. We have already seen the lease, and now we have already also discussed the hire purchase. What are the basic differences between the two? So here, if you based on certain points of distinctions, we can find out the basic difference, because we have already seen both the options of purchase, both the options of acquiring an asset. So in case of lease financing, ownership of asset lies with the lessor. Lessee has the right to use the equipment and does not have the option to purchase. In most of the cases, except the in operating lease and all that, the rights, the lessee cannot become the owner at any point of time. He has to just pay monthly rentals and use the property, but there is no chance of becoming the owner of the property. But in case of hire purchase, in any point of time, when the last installment is paid, the buyer becomes the 100% owner of the asset. So this is what hire purchase's main intention is, to facilitate the buyer by paying the installment purchase system. The intention is not to earn the rentals out of it by the financing organization. Their intention is to earn the interest on the selling, on the loan, and undergo a contract. In case of depreciation, see, depreciation is the salvage in the value of the asset. The asset value by use value goes on decreasing, that you have already studied. So the depreciation is such a component, it is subject to tax reductions. So the claim of the depreciation will be made by the lessor in case of lease contract, because whoso is the owner's only claim can claim the depreciation in the value of the asset, right? And a tax benefit can be sought. So depreciation is always claimed by the lessor in the lease contract. But in case of hire purchase, the depreciation is always claimed by the buyer, not by the financial institutions or loan provider or the transferor of asset called as the owner of the asset. So as the product is in the possession of the hire purchaser, all that depreciation and everything will be shown in the books of accounts of the buyer, not in the owner's name. But in lessee's contract, always the depreciation is shown in the books of accounts of lessor, because the real owner of the asset in lease contract is the lessor only. So then rental payments. In case of lease contract, rental payments covers the cost of the asset, and it also includes the profit portion. But in case of hire purchase, there is no profit portion. There is installment covers the interest and the price of the asset. That is what the rental payments is. Duration. Higher lease contract is for a long period of time. Normally, higher purchase is for a short period of time. It is a short period arrangement for paying the price of the asset and helping the buyer to acquire the asset. And tax impact, if you concern, the total lease payments on the are shown as an expense by the lessee. See, in case of tax impact is concerned, the tax benefit is always in the books of accounts of the lessee. The installment payments, what he makes in the lease contract, the whole amount is shown as a tax rebate in the books of accounts of the lessee. Okay, so the tax benefit is enjoyed. In case of hire purchase claims, depreciation on the asset is an expense only. So the depreciation is claimed by the higher purchaser. So he can show depreciation as a tax exemption possibility in tax payments. But in case of lease contract, the whole amount of the rent what he pays is shown as a rebate on the tax in his total income. Repair and maintenance, if you concerned, responsibility of the lessee in the case of finance lease and of the lessor in case of the operating lease. If you see the repair and all that, in case of operating lease, the lessor is going to incur all the repair and maintenance. Only in case of finance lease, lessee is going to incur the repair and maintenance. But in case of hire purchase, always it lies with the hirer. So repair and maintenance. So the owner of the asset, what you call as the financial institution or the seller of the asset who use it on hire purchase is no way concerned with the repair and maintenance once the hire purchase contract is entered into. It always lies with the purchaser. Extent of financing, it is lease is a complete financing option in which no down payments are required. It is a complete kind of a contract. But in case of hire purchase, down payment is compulsory. Some portion of the money is paid in advance and remaining portion of the price of the value is divided into EMI and the recovery is made. So this is the basic difference between lease and hire purchase contracts. Now we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of hire purchase. One is the first advantage is there is no immediate cash payment of the full value of the asset to acquire it. This is one advantage for the hire purchaser. Hire purchaser can pay installments and acquire the assets. So it reduces the burden of paying the full value of the asset in a single shot and buy the asset. So this is one advantage of this hire purchase. That's why hire purchase is very famous everywhere in the world. Especially for consumer kind of a purchases, it is a boon like. When the goods are available on hire purchase, there will be more demand for the product because the salary holders, the small income earners can acquire any of the assets and whose value is paid in future. So it facilitates the people to acquire the huge costly products which they cannot afford the present situation. The future earnings are adjusted to the value and it can be purchased in the present situation like cars and all that. This is how. Next one is easy possession. The possession of the product can be easily made in a hire purchase because once the contract is entered into and the down payment is made, the possession of the product lies with the purchaser. Purchaser can start using the product immediately when he enters into contract. Then there is an economic growth, basically because when the there is no need to pay the whole value of the product in a single shot when it is purchased on a higher basis. See, the portion of the money which is not paid can be used as a for some other purposes, and that leads to economic growth for the person. Thrift, in the sense the advantage, the thrift refers to advantage or a benefit. There is a huge benefit to the buyer because he can pay a little money and acquire the asset, and asset what he uses starts generating a revenue to him also, especially in case of rickshaws and all that, tangas, rickshaws and all that. The higher buyer purchaser is going to use it for economic purposes and it earns the rent when he uses it. So it gives a help to the person to acquire the asset and this thing. Then relief to buyer. Buyer is relieved from all the tensions of paying the money in advance in single shot. So he can use the assets and pay the installments regularly. But there are certain disadvantages. The disadvantages happens only if certain situation happens. The first one is reputed buyers are only given the option of hire purchase, not everybody, because the credit worthiness of the hire purchaser is most essential for the sellers of the goods on hire purchase. No person is given so easily. So for example, if you are buying a television and all that, either you should give a guarantor for the contract, or you should have a regular salary income where the pay drawing officer should give a guarantee that in case of default happens, his salary will be withheld and the withheld salary will be paid in terms of installment to the seller. Unless and until such kind of reputed buyers are there, these kind of things will not happen. But in lease contract, reputation of the buyer is, reputation of the lessee is not so important, because if the lessee does not pay immediately, the goods are acquired by the lessor at any point of time, because lessor is the owner of the this one. Suppose if you do not pay the house rent, the very next month the buyer, the owner of the house may vacate you and stop that lease contract and transfer that asset to any other person. But in this hire purchase, it does not happen so, because goods cannot be recovered and sold, because the value of the goods becomes zero once it is recovered from the buyer. So many a time these difficulties will arise. Therefore, reputed buyers are only given the chance of hire purchase, and may lead to bankruptcy sometimes if the loan is not recovered by the financial institutions in hire purchase. Bankers becomes the bankrupt because it is called as non-performing asset, where the installment is not received regularly. There is a chance of undergoing a loss, huge loss the asset. Then buyer has to mortgage the property. So mortgage expenses should be borne by the buyer in the higher purchase activity. So this is one additional advantage. It is nothing but registering the asset with the registering authority, where the ownership is in the name of the seller in a higher purchase. Once the last installment is paid, the mortgage deed has to be cancelled, and that the real owner will be, ownership will be the buyer of the assets. So buyer may incur loss. Sometimes buyer may incur loss if because of the interest, heavy interest charged. The total interest charged many a time will be equal to the value of the asset many a time. So this is one disadvantage. Then may lose paid installments in the event of default. If the buyer makes any default and the asset is acquired and sold to the third party, whatever the earlier installments that the buyer has made to the seller becomes waste, because that does not really lead to any ownership of the assets, because asset will be acquired and sold by the seller in case of the default of any EMIs. So that is one more problem. Compared to lease contract, hire purchase is more expensive, because the seller is charging the interest on the outstanding payments of the price. The interest is normally very high, so therefore it is more expensive. And the last one is loss to seller in the event of default by the buyer. If the buyer makes a default, that is loss to the seller, because the seller cannot acquire the property in the same case, because buyer has used as per his will and wish. He has repaired, modified the assets and all that. So sometimes the seller has to lose the identity of the product in the way that it has to be. But in case of lease contract, there is no power to modify the product to the lessee. So lessee has to use the product as it is. But in case of higher purchases, it is not like that. He may deteriorate the value of the product by modifications, repair and all that. Sometimes if it happens, then automatically the seller is under default. So these are all the disadvantages. In the examination, question is normally asked, what is hire purchase? Discuss the advantages and disadvantages. Or the question may also be asked as, what is the differentiate between the hire purchase and the lease contracts? So you should understand all this and write the answer in the examination. So I thank you and end this lecture series, lecture 8. And we will see the remaining aspects in the next class. Thank you. Thank you.